Is Modric better than De Bruyne? Here is our 1v1 opinion. Who has more goals in 2022/2023? Luka Modric or Kevin De Bruyne? Arrow down. Luka Modric has the following offensive skills. He has 4 goals and a total of 6 shots on goals. This results in a goal conversion rate of 6%. He had a total of 0 big chances. Expected goals can only be provided to logged in users. Kevin De Bruyne has the following offensive skills. He has 7 goals and a total of 21 shots on goals. This results in a goal conversion rate of 21%. He had a total of 0 big chances. Who has more assists in 2022/2023? Luka Modric or Kevin De Bruyne? Arrow down. Regarding the passing and playmaking skills, we can see the following picture. Luka Modric has a total of 3 assists, 11 key passes, these are passes leading to a shot on goal, and he created a total of 0 chances. Kevin De Bruyne has a total of 16 assists, 49 key passes, and he created a total of 0 chances. Another important metric to measure the player's performance is the pass completion rate in general, and more importantly the pass completion rate into the opponent's box, because this is where most goals are made. Luka Modric has a pass completion rate of 0% for passes into the box. Kevin De Bruyne has a pass completion rate of 0% for passes into the box. Expected goals, expected goal build-up and expected goal chain value are only visible to our logged-in users. Who is better in defense, Luka Modric or Kevin De Bruyne? Arrow down. Let's have a look at Luka Modric's and Kevin De Bruyne's defensive skills. Luka Modric has a total of 3 blocks, 25 aerial duels and a total number of 5 tackles. Kevin De Bruyne has a total of 2 blocks, 28 aerial duels and a total number of 2 tackles. Summary. Arrow down. Given all statistical values, we believe that Kevin De Bruyne is the better player at the moment. Please feel free to discuss with us, the comment box is below. We will be happy to reply. The reign of Luka Modric has been so long that we cannot imagine him in any other club not wearing a white kit. He also managed to stay in Real Madrid and not get removed by the management, unlike how the other players. This great force of Real Madrid is often called the best midfielder by his fans. The Man City wizard Kevin De Bruyne has done many wonders in his career to make him an ideal candidate to be named the best midfielder. The unique part about De Bruyne is that in order to show the supremacy of other midfielders, they usually compare them to De Bruyne and then call their player the best. If you are being used to compare someone, then it is a sign that you are already the best. In this case, both players have achieved many things in their careers. The two extremely talented midfielders play a very similar role and are perfect in their position. In order to understand who is more dominant, let's compare them on these categories. Point 1. Personal stats. Luka Modric is the type of player who would give an open for his teammate to score, as his main target is helping the team. It is the main reason why Modric does not have shining numbers when it comes to G/contributions, yet people identify his hard work on the field. The Belgian player is more of an attacking midfielder who can play in many positions. He has contributed greatly to the victories of Manchester City down the years. The year 2019 is undoubtedly the best year in the history of Manchester City and De Bruyne, as they won 4 titles in a single season. Although Luka Modric also won the La Liga with Real Madrid, he also had a decent year. The numbers speak for themselves. The Man City midfielder is ahead in terms of G/A, while Modric is more accurate and menacing for the opposing team. Goals win matches and De Bruyne gets more goals for his team. Kevin is the winner of this category. Point 2, titles. The best player of Croatia has won many awards in Spain with Real Madrid. In his career, he won a total of 22 trophies, which includes 4 UEFA Champions League titles, 2 La Liga, 4 CWC titles, 3 Spanish Super Cup and many other titles. The trophy cabinet kept getting bigger even after his critics tried their best to pull him down. The world knows about the glories Kevin and Pep won in the Premier League. A number of critics claimed De Bruyne to be the main reason for their recent glory in England. The Belgian midfielder has lifted 16 titles in his career. He won 3 Premier League titles, 1 FA Cup, 1 German Cup and other titles in his early career in Belgium. We have a clear winner in this category. Luka Modric triumphs in this category. International career. Luka Modric started his international career early as he joined the U-15 team of Croatia. The journey was difficult as he came from a war-struck background with many tragic events happening when he was a kid. Modric loved to play for his country Croatia. He is the most capped player in the history of Croatia and easily the best man on the team for a long time. The player contributed considerably to the FIFA 2018 World Cup and led his team to the finals. The national team of Belgium is always filled with promising talents every year, yet they fail to lift any title. In his international career, Kevin did not win anything with his country. The player has given remarkable performances for his country in the past yet did not manage to achieve it. There is no comparison with Luka Modric for the country. A legend of Croatia. Individual honors. According to pundits of football, the only way to compare midfielders is through individual honors. If a player performs well, then he will surely be rewarded even if his team does not win anything major. The list is long and it is difficult to compare as each award holds different importance and experience for them. Individual honors of Kevin De Bruyne. Bundesliga Young Player of the Year, 2012-13. Bundesliga Player of the Year, 2014-15. Bundesliga Team of the Year, 2014-15. UEFA Europa League Squad of the Season, 2014-15. Footballer of the Year, Germany 2015. Manchester City Player of the Season, 2015-16, 2017-18, 2019-20. Manchester City Goal of the Season, 2019-20. FIFA FAF Pro World 11, 2020 IFFHS Men's World Team, 2017-2019-2020. UEFA Team of the Year, 2017-2019-2020. ESM Team of the Year, 2017-18, 2019-20, 2020-21. PFA Premier League Team of the Year, 2017-18, 2019-20, 2020-21. Premier League Playmaker of the Season, 2017-18, 2019-20. UEFA Champions League Squad of the Season, 2017-18, 2018-19, 2019-20, 2020-21. FIFA World Cup Dream Team, 2018. Premier League Player of the Season, 2019-20. PFA Players Player of the Year, 2019-20, 2020-21 UEFA Champions League Midfielder of the Season, 2019-20. IFFHS World's Best Playmaker, 2020. IFFHS UEFA Team of the Decade, 2011-2020. Club. Kevin De Bruyne. KAA Gent Youth Academy found Kevin and he played for most of his early career for them. After 7 years, Chelsea decided to sign him in 2012. It was a big move for Kevin to move into the Premier League. The player failed to perform with Chelsea and was eventually sold to Wolfsburg. After moving to Germany, he worked hard on his game and was starting to get media attention. When Manchester City made a bid on Kevin, many other teams were interested in him. The player decided to join Man City and it has been his home since then. Is Modric better than De Bruyne? Kevin De Bruyne is an absolute genius who can attack, dribble and assist his team. The shots made by De Bruyne are accurate and his passes often